大家好，我是 Stella，
我是 Warren。 今天为您念的是练习手册下篇十一，何谓造化？ What is creation？
造化是上主所有圣念的总称，其数无限，无所不在，且无边无际。 Creation is the sum of all God's thoughts in number infinite and everywhere without all limit。 唯有爱才有创造的能力，而且只能造出与自己相似之物。 Only love creates and only like itself。 没有一刻爱的创造不存在。 There was no time where all that it created was not there。 也没有一刻爱的创造会受失落之苦。Nor will there be a time when anything that it created suffers all loss. 上主的圣念过去如何，今日亦然，永恒如此，不论在时间领域内，时间结束后，它永远千古不易。Forever and forever are God's thoughts, exactly as they were and as they are, unchanged through time and after time is done. 上主的圣念具备了造物主所有的能力。 God's thoughts are given all the power that their own creator has. 爱会因着他推恩之力而更为真实。For he would add to love by its extension.他的圣旨既然享有造化的一切，必也享有创造的能力。 Thus his son shares in creation and must therefore share in power to create. 凡是在上主旨意中永为一体的生命，直到时间的终结依然一体，即使在时空之内也不可能改变这一本质，他仍是时间之念兴起以前的面目。What God has willed to be forever one will still be one when time is over, and will not be changed throughout the course of time, remaining as it was before the thought of time began. 造化与幻象恰恰相反，因造化属于真相。Creation is the opposite of all illusions, for creation is the truth.造化即是神圣的上主之子，他的旨意圆满地呈现于造化的每一部分，每一部分也都蕴含了他的整个生命。 Creation is the Holy Son of God, for in creation is his will complete in every aspect, making every part container of the whole.造化的一体性保证永不受侵犯， Its oneness is forever guaranteed, inviolate, forever held within his holy will, beyond all possibility of harm, of separation, imperfection, and of any spot upon its sinlessness. 我们就是这个造化，我们就是上主之子。We are creation, we are the sons of God. 虽然我们活得好似互不相关，平素也感受不到我们与他永远一体的生命。We seem to be discrete and unaware of our internal unity with him.然而在所有的疑惧之后，在所有的恐惧之上，我们心中始终存有某种肯定。 Yet, back of all our doubts, past all our fears, there still is certainty. 因为爱一直与自己所有的圣念同在，他们必也拥有与爱一般的肯定不移。For love remains with all its thoughts, its sureness being theirs. 上主的记忆就是我们神圣的心灵内，他们深知彼此是一个生命，也与造物主一体不分。 God's memory is in our holy minds, which know their oneness and their unity with their Creator. 愿我们仅以恢复这一记忆为己任。That our function be only to let the memory return, only to let God's will be done on earth, only to be restored to sanity and to be but as God created us. 天父在向我们召唤。Our Father calls to us. 我们听见了他的天音，因造物主之名而宽恕了整个造化。这位造物主即是那神圣的本体，一切造化都分享了他的神圣本质。这神圣本质始终是我们生命的一部分。We hear His voice, and we forgive creation in the name of its Creator, holiness itself.Whose holiness his own creation shares, whose holiness is still a part of us. 恳恩要我们参考正文第六章第二节第八段，圣旨是在上主延伸其圣念之际造出的，凡是由圣念延伸出去的，必然依旧存于天心之内。God created his sons by extending his thought and retaining the extensions of his thought in his mind. 因此，他所有的圣念不只本身是完美的一体，彼此之间也互为一体。All his thoughts are thus perfectly united within themselves and with each other.圣灵方能当下帮你认出他的圆满无缺。The Holy Spirit enables you to perceive this wholeness now. 正文第七章第一节第二段第三句，上主把创造的圣念传给了你，你也必须将自己的创造之念传给你的创造。 As God's creative thought proceeds from him to you, so must your creative thought proceed from you to your creations. 所有的创造能力均是循此途径而推恩出去的。 Only in this way can all creative power extend outward. 第三段第三句，创造的力量即是爱的力量。To create is to love. 爱必有推恩之力，没有东西阻挠得了它。Love extends outward simply because it cannot be contained. 它是无限的，故永无止境。Being limitless, it does not stop.第七句，上主的创造一向如此，因为他自己一向如此。God's creations have always been because he has always been. 你的创造也一向如此，因为你只能像上主一般的创造。Your creations have always been because you can create only as God creates. 正文第五章第六节第一段，在真知中，上主是一无所待的，是你的等待拖延使他的天国荒芜。 God in his knowledge is not waiting, but his kingdom is bereft while you wait. 第三句，拖延在永恒中并不是问题，但对活在时间中的人却是个悲剧。Delay does not matter in eternity, but it is tragic in time. 你既然选择了时间而非永恒，自然会认为自己受限于时间。You have elected to be in time rather than eternity, and therefore believe you are in time. 第六句，你原本不是活在时间内的。You do not belong in time. 永恒才是你的家乡，那是上主亲自为你准备的永恒居所。Your place is only in eternity, where God Himself placed you forever. 正文第八章第八节第一段第十句，整体能够界定部分，部分却无法界定整体。The whole does define the part, but the part does not define the whole. 然而，一旦知道部分的真相，你便知道了整体的真相，这是真知与知见的根本不同之处。Yet, to know in part is to know entirely because of the fundamental difference between knowledge and perception. 在知见领域内，整体是由部分组合而成的，各个部分能够分分合合，建构为不同的组合。In perception, the whole is built up of parts that can separate and reassemble in different constellations. 但真知之性是永恒不变的，故它的组合必也恒常不变。But knowledge never changes, so its constellation is permanent.只有在变幻无常的知见领域，才有所谓的整体与部分的关系。The idea of part-whole relationships has meaning only at the level of perception where change is possible. 超越了知见层次之后，部分与整体之间其实毫无差别。Otherwise, there is no difference between the part and正文第二十六章第一节第六段，你可以不看那一整体性，但你牺牲不了一体性。You can lose sight of oneness, but cannot make sacrifice of its reality. 即使你有意牺牲，也不会示弱他的，因你阻碍不了圣灵的工作，他迟早会让你明白，你从未示弱一体性。Nor can you lose what you would sacrifice, nor keep the Holy Spirit from his task of showing you that it has not been lost. 正文第十八章第八节第五段，凡是自认为活在身体内的人，全都脱离不了这种怪异的境况。Such is the strange position in which those in a world inhabited by bodies seem to be. 每一具身体里面好似住着一个独立的心灵，一个互不相通之念，孤独地活着自己的生命，无法与创造他的神念相通。Each body seems to house a separate mind,A disconnected thought, living alone and in no way joined to the thought by which it was created. 每一个碎片看起来好似自给自足，偶尔也得依赖其他部分，但绝不至于全然依赖它唯一的造物主，或是需要生命本体赋予它存在的意义，只因它本身没有任何意义。Each tiny fragment seems to be self-contained, needing another for some things, but by means totally independent on its one creator for everything, needing the whole to give it any meaning.For by itself, it does mean nothing. 正文第十三章第十一节第九段第三句话，救恩也像上主一般万无一失。Salvation is as sure as God. 他的千古不易即是最大的保证。His certainty suffices.你会学到，阴森的梦魇最多只能搅乱上主之子沉睡的心灵，并没有控制他的能力。Learn that even the darkest nightmare that disturbs the mind of God's sleeping son holds no power over him. 他终会学成这一觉醒的课程的。He will learn the lesson of awakening. 因上主始终眷顾着他，光明与他片刻不离。God watches over him and light surrounds him. 第十段三，即使睡眠也抵挡不了唤醒他的呼声。His sleep will not withstand the call to wake. 救赎大业注定会圆满成功，就如造化的千古不易那般必然。The mission of redemption will be fulfilled as surely as the creation will remain unchanged throughout eternity. 即使你不知天堂原本属于你所有，天堂依旧非你莫属。You do not have to know that heaven is yours to make it so. 因为本来如是 ，it is so.最后我们来看正文第十四章第十节第三段，只要你肯让他化解那蒙蔽你圣洁心灵之真相的一切障碍，和活在天父的恩典中，他就会将自己的生命赐予你，一如往昔。 When you have let all that obscured the truth in your most holy mindbe undone for you, and therefore stand in grace before your Father. He will give himself to you as he has always done. 第四句，你无需祈求上天宽恕，因那早已完成了。Ask not to be forgiven, for this has already been accomplished.你应祈求的乃是学习如何宽恕，让你看见自己不宽恕的心灵所视而不见的真相。Ask rather to learn how to forgive and to restore what always was to your unforgiving mind. 第七句，这是你在世上唯一的任务，但你必须先认出这是你唯一想要学习知识才行。On earth, this is your only function, and you must learn that it is all you want to learn. 第四段第五句，决心承认你对自己看走了眼吧，只有上主对你的看法才是正确的。Decide that God is right, and you are wrong about yourself. 愿你有一个圣灵充满的一天。Amen.
以上是练习手册下篇，何谓造化 ？What is creation？ 愿大家有一个圣灵充满的一天啊！我爱你哦。